2017 onwards, you have been building this amazing startup. So can you tell us about your initial days?
Before it became Leverage Edu, it was Leverage. So this was my entrepreneurship project back when I was doing my MBA in 2014. Leverage in its initial form in 2014-15 was an Android app that was up to be a marketplace for career advice. So we kind of just like most startups do, and I was 24 years old then. We said, okay, let's just launch this on the Android thing and let's apply to a bunch of these programs. So the way our platform used to move back in the day was students used to find mentors who are like them on the marketplace, and these mentors used to give them career advice. In return, mentors would get karma points, which they could essentially redeem at, say, a Pizza Hut, a Starbucks or things like that. But there was no business as such. In April 2017, Leverage became Leverage Edu. Became a combination of that mentorship platform and my exposure to higher education and the whole overseas sector. Basically, be very student first in our approach. We will always think about the aspiration of the student. If the aspiration of the student is X, we'll try to basically make it A. And that's how kind of we built up the model, which is very different. We focus on the student. We charge the students than the universities. So while we are in the college admission space, largely from market perspective, our focus is a lot more, because of our background, the focus is a lot more on the career. And we're saying that, hey, we are not essentially just using our platform to get to a college. There's a pre and post to it. Pre means that we are doing a bunch of workshops for you with a mentor on the marketplace to ensure that you're super ready when you get into the college, be it undergraduate or postgraduate degree. And once you kind of graduate out of there, we also give you a network so that you get the right jobs in that country. So students essentially come on our platform from grade 8 onwards, and those are our youngest consumers, and all the way up to somebody who could be, say, a 29 or 30 or 31. So somebody in grade 8 could be looking at a mentorship program where they're coming in and saying that, hey, I'll spend an year on your platform, I'll take up a subscription, a monthly or a quarterly subscription, and I will go through a very intense workshop curriculum where you are helping me prepare for what's next for me in terms of my career, in terms of my higher education, so on and so forth. Essentially, people coming for undergraduate and postgraduate programs and saying that, hey, I'm looking to apply to XYZ colleges, or help me, I'm looking to go to the US, help me figure out what are the right colleges for me. And then they essentially do their workshops. We help them with their applications. We help them with the scholarship platform, which is embedded into the entire thing. And then we also essentially add a bunch of value-added services to it, which essentially means that once this person gets the admit, we'll also help them with their education loan, their forex, their visa, their accommodation, and like we have a bunch of partners spread across the world to essentially do that. So a student would be paying, depending on the program that they're enrolling for, anywhere between 20,000 rupees to 2 lakh rupees. So if somebody's applying to colleges like a Harvard Business School and an MIT, and a Columbia, and for which the people on our marketplace would be from those colleges and who have that level of experience, so they will be slightly more expensive for us to also kind of get onto the platform, get onto the marketplace. To say somebody who's not looking at a whole immersive experience, but looking at, hey, I already know what colleges I want to get to. This is a program that I'm really kind of set my eyes on. I want to do food technology in the UK. These are the colleges that I'm really keen on. Help me get through these colleges. And then the team has a slightly low-touch engagement there, where they're helping this person with their applications and so on and so forth. So a large part of the whole immersive experience is kind of not needed with a bunch of these guys. So hence the range kind of really varies, all the way from 15-20k all the way up to 2 lakh rupees, depending on the engagement on the platform that these guys would have.
So do you also work as an HR consultancy?
We get paid only by the students right now. Okay. On the college side, we don't charge a commission as a normal, as a lot of other folks do.
Mm-hmm.
But we do help them to build out their brand in India, to essentially help them with a bunch of additional marketing services. So that's a very small B2B portion of the business, where we are saying that, hey, if you have a particular supply to fill in, we can essentially partner with you. And we help you build a brand that can essentially get you better quality of intake.
Akshay, are you focusing on growth or profitability right now?
So I think it's a very clear answer. We focus on growth, out and out growth. Our revenues have been growing at, just to give you a number, our monthly revenues have grown by over 300% over the last couple of months. So we've kind of really put our foot on the accelerator and saying that thanks to the great support we have from our institutional investors, saying that, hey, can we, because the market is really out there, the market is very deep, the market is very big, can we go out and service more people? And because what also happens when you are able to get to more people is the network effects kick in. In our business, every single time there is a happy student, the happy student goes out and talks to five more people who essentially you don't have to spend money on to acquire the student. And this student is kind of walking onto our platform and saying that, hey, I also want the same thing that my friend wanted.
Yeah.
So I think we are seeing those flywheel effects kick in to a certain degree. That said, to answer the first part of your question, we've been profitable. We've been profitable in certain months last fiscal. But we've realized that this business is a switch on from a profitability and growth perspective. And
how did you close your FY 2019?
So we grew our revenues 2x from the first year to the second year. And this year we're looking at our revenue from last year should essentially go 3 to 4 times over the last year.
Can you share a number?
So right now I'll share the annual. We're on an annualized revenue run rate of 10 crore plus right now.
What are your plans in terms of expansion for your user base or your geographies? Or are you going to come up with more verticals in your system?
I think back in the day, we used to feel that, hey, let's very quickly get to 10 cities and get everybody to experience services. But we have realized that right now, for us to grow, just certain focus on certain cities is kind of good enough. So focus on Delhi, Bangalore and Bombay as markets. But we do get organic queries from say a tier 5 or tier 6 cities like a Tillur and like and all of these places as well. So we solve these queries because it's an online platform.
You don't have a lot of offline operations, right? So even if you're present only in 3 cities with offices.
Correct. So what we've seen is sometimes when people really want to, because it's slightly higher up the category. So essentially when somebody is really not, because if you traditionally look at the space, it's a very trust deficit category. So it's okay if somebody from Andhra Pradesh would essentially say that, yeah, I can do my entire transaction online. A Bangalore Delhi person would say that. But somebody from a village in Punjab, where it's a very trust deficit place, would say that, hey, the last person told me that I can go to Canada and he ran away with the 1 lakh rupees. So he would say, hey, I want to still make sure that you're a legit company. Do you have a board put somewhere? So these are some challenges that we still face in the business because the market has traditionally been like that. So it becomes really important for us to have some kind of basic physical presence, some kind of basic offline modes for that person to essentially bridge that trust gap. And hence the focus on expanding into different geographies over time. And the idea is to expand into more vertical categories. We've seen that with medical, we're seeing that with a bunch of other categories around architecture. So on and so forth, and that is going to be a key focus as we deep dive next year.
Got it. So on that note, wishing all the best to Leverage Edu for a wonderful journey.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.